Ahead of the International Women's Day on March 8th, NatConnect Foundation, in association with Viviana Mall, we have floated an online petition focusing on the increasing incidence of domestic violence.
You are hurting me, Harish. Please, let go.
Domestic violence has become quite rampant, particularly during the lockdown period, but due to various socio-economic reasons, and many people are even now are scared to complain about such incidents.
Hi Riya, how are you?
Good. Ma'am, board pe Riya ki drawing nahi dikhi.
Riya, aap jao games room mein khelo. I'll call you.
Mrs. Sharma, Riya ki drawing kaafi disturbing. Isliye board pe nahi laga.
Kiran, Domestic Violence Act ke तहत आपके पति को पहले सिर्फ वार्निंग दी जाएगी और एक प्रोटेक्शन ऑफिसर अपॉइंट किया जाएगा जो कि उनके बर्ताव पे नजर रख सके. इमरजेंसी में मेडिकल और होम शेल्टर फैसिलिटीज भी, और इतना ही नहीं, राष्ट्रीय महिला आयोग की भी मदद ले सकती हैं आप.
हेलो व्यूअर्स, वेलकम टू एट अनदर इंटरेस्टिंग चैट ऑन द कनेक्ट.टीवी. टुडे वी हैव रीमा कीर्तिका, हु इज सीएमओ ऑफ द विवियाना मॉल. Of course, other than handling the marketing part of the mall, Rima also handles the some CSR initiatives being taken by the establishment. They have an initiative called hashtag Mera Farz Hai, and I believe you started it last year, Rima? You started Mera Farz Hai last year?
Yes. 2020 was the first time we had this Mera Farz Hai. Okay. But we do a special initiative during Women's Day. And yeah. We have a property known extraordinary.
As the expression, as the word denotes, Mera Farz Hai means my responsibility. I think much before the government
Absolutely.
And others have started my responsibility, I think Rima and company have started it. Let's hear from Rima as to what is this initiative all about and how you started it. Rima.
Hi everybody, thank you so much for viewing us. We at Viviana Mall always believe that mall is just not a place, but it's a community center. So whenever we are like little off with our mood or we bunk college, we're always at the mall doing some kind of an entertainment for ourselves. So we said that as a mall, we get a platform where millions of people are coming to the mall. Why don't we do an initiative which can be a game changer for somebody's lives individually? So Extraordinary is a property which we launched in 2015. So we did a lot of aspects under this Extraordinary. Initially, we used to find out extraordinary talent amongst the women who have not recognized, reward them every year. And gradually, we got a little different roadmap towards this entire activity. In 2018, we did an activity with acid attack survivors. We did a fashion show. Nobody ever would have thought like these acid attack victims would actually walk up the ramp and show their inner beauty. We were talking about acceptance and we were asking people, you know, to ban acid sale. Stop acid sale was the motto behind doing this kind of a show. In 2019, we did something very different again, once again. We were talking about respect women on wheelchair. So here, okay. Women on wheelchair are always looked down. So how about getting them respect? So that was an initiative which we did. Was a year when we talked about Mera Farz Hai. Now, Mera Farz Hai as a concept, we're talking about it's my responsibility. Rather than blaming onto somebody else, ye karega, wo karega, isne nahi kiya, usne nahi kiya, we're talking about Mera Farz Hai. Let's just put our foot down and say, let me take some step and doing some kind of and change in the entire society.
Sorry. What's How dare you touch my phone?
My Amira Farzai was primarily all about violence against women. So what we were talking about is basically how do we create respect for women and violence wherein, you know, misbehavior at public places or offices or when you're traveling in the bus, what kind of experience a woman has to go wherein she has to face all this problem by herself because nobody is coming up and helping her at that point of time. Last year, with the help of Thane Police, we did a small video wherein, you know, the awareness of 103 as a number. This is the police helpline number wherein people can call up on this number and ask for help individually or in case they can see something is happening, they can report.
And what was last year's campaign about?
This was about violence against women. So we are talking sexual harassment.
Harassment at the workplace. Sexual harassment. Yeah.
Harassment at workplace or even sexual harassment in the bus, like a public transport, if somebody is brushing, you know, if you're standing and somebody's just trying to play your hands on, or if you're even in a public place like a pub, if you somebody's pushing on a drink onto you or pushing themselves onto you. So we had touched all the strata of society. It was not like only lower society would have all these problems.
Aapki khamoshi kiska hausla badha rahi hai?
Sir. Rook.
Excuse me. Mera farz hai.
Mera farz hai.
Mera farz hai.
क्राइम होते देखें तो तुरंत 103 पर सूचित कर.
Now coming back to 103, does 103 also help in this kind of situations? What was the experience with the police?
So, police has been really very supportive, right? From last year onwards, we started interacting with them on day-to-day basis with what's happening. So, 103 is an helpline which helps any kind of problems for a women. So, this is a women helpline altogether. So, in case there is a trouble which a woman is facing by herself, she can dial on this number. The van would come and immediately help them. In case of domestic violence also, 103 is the number which people can call up and register the complaint and the action is taken by the nearest police station.
To turant 103 par suchit kare.
Mahilon ke khilaf bad rahe sexual harassment ka apradhon ko rokne ke liye awaz uthaye 103 par call kare. Mahila suraksha mera farz hai aur aapka bhi.
Stop sexual harassment when you see it. An initiative by Viviana Mall.
You know, we saw that short film that you made with along with the Thane Police. How was the film taken? How was it received?
So last year when we did this video in around March this year, 18 million as of now, we have got 18 million views on that video. It was played in more than 150 cinemas. And the program, what we wanted to do is we basically wanted to do a lot of sessions going back to colleges and telling them to respect women from then. Because Indian society still has that little bias towards, you know, a female and a male child. Their, you know, thinking changed. Unfortunately, because of the lockdown, we couldn't take up that initiative. But still, we are facing a problem that schools have still not started. But yeah, very soon, when things come back to normal, we want to go ahead and get into, you know, training of, you know, how do you change your mentality towards women in the society. At the beginning itself, when the child is really small, if we start building the confidence that, you know, you have to take care of a lady, that will really help him when he grows as a man.
You know, lockdown has affected all of us in more than one way. It has made us sit at home and work. Of course, work from home has become a new norm today. And of course, also because of the smaller families, nucleus families, you know, these and smaller homes, work from home, from home as a novelty was okay in the beginning. But I think subsequently, it is not gone down very well with many people. What has been your feedback?
Absolutely brilliant, bang on. You know, this is exactly what our campaign for this year is. Another thing which we have seen across, increase in domestic violence. There was crazy amount of, it was around 44% increase in domestic, if I have to talk about stats. So during that particular period, there were 45% more registration which happened towards domestic violence cases. That means there were too many things which were coming out. Only 44% numbers which I'm talking about are registered. Most of them were not even registered. People didn't know what to do about, scared people, you know, multiple things. So that's how
this is normally the people are very passive to these kind of things. Suppose in my neighborhood something happens, there is a, you know, shooting going on, like your film shows. I think the message about that dog, you know, can be on you also. That stain will be on you if you keep ignoring this. Yes. I think that's very, very strong message.
अगर आप खामोश हैं, तो ये
Yeah, so exactly this is what, sir, we wanted to bring it across to people. If you see, if you're not the one, you're the lucky one that you're not facing domestic violence. But if you can hear somebody, you know, having some kind of a problem, please raise your voice. A lot of people feel, ye mera problem nahi hai, and just want to sneak out of it. But no, I think we should all take initiative. We should all work towards the betterment. And exactly the concept of dag, you know, that blood stains are also on you. If you don't, you know, go ahead and, you know, if you see the entire video, the guy with the headphones, there is no stain on his hand. Exactly, because why he dials up 103? He's asking for help. Even if you don't want to do individually, you please ask for help. Police is sitting there. Police is there to help you out. So why don't we take that opportunity of taking help from them, at least raising your voice.
आप खामोश हैं, तो ये दाग आप पर भी है. Domestic violence होते देखे, तो तुरंत 103 पर सूचित करें.
Rima, it's not the question of not having enough awareness. People are aware. Only thing is people are a bit hesitant. Like it happens, you know, like, you know, it used to happen in the case of accidents, like the road accident, you know, while passing by, I see an accident. If I take that patient to the hospital, there'll be 1,000 questions asked by the hospital itself and the cop on duty, policeman on duty also ask, where were you? What were you doing? I mean, you're scared of apprehensive of all these questions from the police, number one, number two, and going to the court, you know, as a witness. So all those hassles are there. Now, of course, after a long battle, the government has come out with a law that a good Samaritan, like, you know, people who take these patients to hospitals are not answerable to the law. So I think something like should be done. I think it's a brilliant idea that we have come up with this petition, online petition to Smriti Irani. Your thoughts on that, Rima?
So exactly, sir, what you are trying to, you know, that's a problem. Nobody wants to come ahead. And even if, as a victim, if I was a victim today, I had to again share the same house with my husband. So yeah. Where do I go? What do I do? If even if I go to a cop, that cop will say, okay, I will talk to your husband, and probably he's back to the house. After that, what happens to me? And as a lady, I'm a little timid with probably no earnings, child around with me. What do I do? So this is exactly which we are talking to the government. In case there is a problem which a lady arises with, please give her a solution. Give her some shelter wherein till those things are a little curbed down, she's there, you know. Because rather than getting scared of what, because I have to live with him, you know, that's like a biggest fear.
Yeah.
Before even approaching to a cop, I have to come back and, you know, stay under the same roof. That's like a biggest trauma anybody would face.
Yeah.
Exactly to these points we're talking about. You know, we want government intervention. We want rules to get a little solid, wherein women or anybody for that matter, you know, even if a male is fine facing some domestic issues, definitely he should ask for help. you know, we have also found out there are also problems with male faces. It's not only a women centric.
Lot of people say that there is a patni pidit sangatna somewhere in Nasik, and they also come. I said how dare a man can speak against woman.
We will take this up with the men's day. You know, right now it's women's. So we are talking about women because women number is large.
No, but actually every day is women's day because as you said in that petition, starting from the prime minister to the junior KG student, all of us have been taught to respect women. Ma devi hoti hai, ma hai, wife hai, sister hai. Women has several roles to play in the society, in the family. Even to take case of education, if you say that if a man is educated, a man is educated. If you educate a woman, a society gets educated. A family gets educated, a society gets educated. So that's the importance that as a society we have been giving it rather. But despite all this, you know, the crimes, the domestic violence, all these things keep happening.
Sorry. What sorry? How dare you touch my phone?
I was dying.
Out.
Beat dowry, beat the harassment, you know, all this. So I think there's a need to educate even the men folk in this connection. You know, like we spoke about the sexual harassment in workplaces. It is sensitizing the boys, sensitizing the men is equally important.
Absolutely, absolutely.
So that's where I think the initiatives like yours come in. I'm very happy that the NetConnect Foundation has agreed to, and we have worked together on this. And let's try and make this a grand success.
Absolutely. Look forward for everybody's support. No, I just want everybody to come ahead, sign the petition, which we want to reach up to the government and support us so that, you know, we really can do together some changes for our womenhood.
Also, I think as a solution, instead of leaving everything to the government, I think the NGOs, a lot of social organizations, the police, of course, and the women police, NCW, all of us should work together to work out a PPP model.
Absolutely.
So great. Nice talking to you, Arima. We'll be in touch.
So that's how we have connected with NAT. Thank you so much. So absolutely, absolutely. So we have connected with NAT Connect Foundation for, signing up our petition. So we request more associations to join us and, solve this problem altogether.
Right now, many people are trapped in their homes with an abuser. This is the shadow pandemic. In one weekend, calls to domestic abuse helplines in the UK went up by 65%. In the US, Asia, and pretty much everywhere, reported numbers are rising. These aren't just numbers, they're people you might know. If you think someone is in trouble, check in on them. Ask them if they're okay and if everything at home is okay. Educate yourself about domestic violence. Know the details of local services like helpline numbers or shelters. If she tells you or you suspect that her life or the lives of her children are in immediate danger, call the protection units or the police. The shadow pandemic is spreading right now. Let's help each other safely right now.
Thank you very much for watching the Connect TV channel. We are sure you liked our coverage. Please subscribe to the Connect TV by pressing the bell icon. Please subscribe by pressing the bell icon. Thank you very much.